It's actually been quite a bit of travel getting down here thus far. It's insanity. Let me get rid of this, let me get rid of this marker right here real quick. Alright. To the Commonwealth. But we are in the Commonwealth, but you know what I mean! I don't need to explain myself. Except I totally do. But now that it's daytime, it's a little easier for me to see everything, that's at least good. Hopefully I don't find anything else pretty big and terrifying. Fraternal Post 115. Oh, this is a college campus. Damn. Alright, cool. I'll check out the college campus eventually. An ice cream shop. Dog meat's looking for things. I don't know what he's looking for, but I'll... guess I'll look as well. A lot of pre-war money I can sell. Again, the concept of selling money is just funny to me in many different ways. Oh, more 45 rounds. Preservation shelter. Toy alien. Wooden blocks. And a lunchbox. And it's got quantum in it! That's the best lunchbox yet. Anything that has Nuka-Cola quantum in it is just amazing. Okay, so I guess here's Diamond City. Here we are. I lost the military signal, but that's okay. Wreck of the USS Riptide. Wait, is this not Diamond City? Dogmeat, you need to move. Dogmeat, you need to move. I hear people. I do hear people. I'll check them out eventually. In the meantime, you still have places to go. There you go. You're not stuck anymore. That's gonna be a good mod. When they fix the AI a little bit, that'd be good. Like the move it, damn it, mod for Skyrim. That's a pretty good mod. I hear bullets again. I got my gun, and a lot of ammo for it too. I am not comfortable with the amount of gunfire that is being shot right now. What? What the hell are those? Mutants already? Oh my god, okay. Did you just fucking hit me? He's pretty big. He's got a big gun. And I'm taking bullets in my face. Oh my god! Oh my god, I'm gonna die. I quick saved in such a bad spot. Legendary super mutants. I really hope that legendary is not on top of me. That would suck so bad. Regardless, I'm going back over here for the moment. What's the frag mine look like? Where is he? There he is. My god, he takes so much damage. There's gotta be something else I can do. Inventory. I guess I could throw a grenade at him. Nah, fuck it. The best option I have is just continue using this gun. Where is he? Went inside. This is probably an awful idea, but I'm going in. I'm not going in at all, actually. Wait, yes I am. Dog meat, what the fuck? Mutant Slayer Raider's left leg. Oh my god. I will definitely take that. In fact, I'll equip that right now, too. Man, these super mutants are no joke. This is... I'm not gonna lie, I have a permanent smile on my face right now. I can't get rid of this. Glow sight at the top. That was needed. Right on bones. I don't need bones. Oh, I do and I don't. It's a weird thing to explain. Oh. Oh, man. At least he died like a boss with some cigarettes. If you die with some cigarettes, you know, you just win. Where's that security? Where did they go? Yo.
Damn. Not afraid of mutants, huh? You're our kind of guy.
I'm a cool guy that doesn't afraid of anything, sir. And you will do well to understand this, because I'm very scared and might need your help soon enough. Okay. That was a hell of a thing. They got turrets. They got a whole bunch of stuff here, man. Dogmeat, what are you finding?
Gonna be a good I'll wear your guts around my neck.
Oh my god. Okay. No, Dogmeat, we're leaving. Damn it, dog meat. Why you gotta keep making it so that people keep finding us? Okay, that's one more dead. I'll take this. Apparently, they're throwing Molotovs at me now. Oh, there's another one. You know what? Fuck this, I'm running. Dogmeat, run. Dogmeat, run! If they follow me, they're crazy. Dogmeat, come on! We're okay in here. This is Diamond City, we should be safe here.
Nothing to see here.
I mean, if you say so.
Hey,
Dogmeat, get over here.
How you doing, buddy?
This is a fucking weird UI. They need to fix this. Oh my god. That is a terrible
UI
right there.
The wall ain't safe. That's just
how
it is.
Can't open the gate. Stop playing around, Danny. I'm standing out in the open here for crying out loud.
I got orders not to let you in, Miss Piper. I'm sorry. I'm just doing my job.
Ooh, just doing your job. Protecting Diamond City means keeping me out, is that it? Oh, look, it's the scary reporter.
I'm sorry, but Mayor McDonough's really steamed, Piper. Saying that article you wrote was all lies. The whole city's in a tizzy.
You open this gate right now, Danny Sullivan. I live here. You can't just lock me out.
Can I help you?
You. You want into Diamond City, right?
Yes. Who are you?
What? Who are you?
Shh. Play along. What's that? You said you're a trader up from Quincy? You have enough supplies to keep the general store stocked for a whole month? You hear that, Danny? You gonna open the gate and let us in, or are you gonna be the one talking to crazy Myrna about losing out on all the supply?
Jeez, all right. No need to make it personal, Piper. Give me a minute.
Better head inside quick before old Danny catches on to the bluff.
I don't appreciate that you used me, ma'am. I can't move either.
Sounds good. Let's go.
Another great day in Diamond City.
So, from what I've heard, this is the game's version of Megaton.
Piper, who let you back inside? I told Sullivan to keep that gate shut. You devious, rabble-rousing slanderer. The level of dishonesty in that paper of yours. I'll have that printer scrap for parts.
Ooh, that a statement, Mr. McDonough? Tyrant mayor shuts down the press. Why don't we ask the newcomer? You support the news? Because the mayor's threatened to throw free speech in the dumpster.
Lady, I just got here, okay?
This really isn't any of my business.
Oh, I didn't mean to bring you into this argument, good sir. No. You look like Diamond City material. Welcome to the great green jewel of the Commonwealth. Safe, happy, a fine place to come. Spend your money. Settle down. Don't let this muckraker here tell you otherwise, all right?
What are you two arguing about?
What are you two arguing about, anyway?
What do you think? Print lies and everybody's happy, but if you print the truth...
Now, was there anything particular you came to our city for?
Missing person.
I'm trying to find someone.
Trying to find someone? Who?
My son.
My son. Sean. He's less than a year old.
Wait, your son's missing? Oh, you hear that, McDonough? What's Diamond City Security doing to help this man, huh? This isn't the first missing persons report to come through here, and now we have an infant who's been taken?
Don't listen to her. Well, I'm afraid that our security team can't follow every case that comes through. I'm confident that you can find help here. Diamond City has every conceivable service known to man. One of our great citizens can surely find the time to help you.
Well, sure. And a mayor of a great city must know everyone. Who can help me?
Well, there is one private citizen, Nick Valentine, a detective of sorts who specializes in tracking people down, usually for debts or whatnot. No,
oh.
I have to get going.
Okay.
I'm sorry, Diamond City Security doesn't have time to help, but I'm sure Mr. Valentine charges a reasonable fee.
This is ridiculous. Diamond City Security can't spare one officer to help. I want the truth, McDonough. What's the real reason security never investigates?
I've had enough of this, Piper. From now on, consider you and that little sister of yours on notice.
Yeah, keep talking, McDonough. That's all you're good for. I'm impressed. Not everyone can claw information out of McDonough's tight-fisted hands. Why don't you stop by my office after you see Valentine? I think I just found my next story.
I still don't appreciate that you used me, lady. But, you know, that's okay. Dogmate, what are you doing?
Head on inside.
Okay.
Hey.
Hey.
So, you're that traitor Piper was talking about. Something tells me she's pulled the wool over my eyes again. Am I right?
Yeah.
I didn't mean to lie, officer. It all just happened so fast.
You're not the first guy Piper pulled into a heap of trouble he wasn't ready for. Thanks for being honest. If it were up to me, we would have just let the both of you in. But the mayor's calling the shots, and... well, you saw how mad he is. Anyway, welcome to Diamond City and all that. I gotta get back to work.
Alright, cool. At least Danny is not an asshole. I'll accept that. I like it when people are nice to each other. Alright, I guess here comes my first view of Diamond City. I have no idea what it looks like. I really need to get more mines. They're probably going to be my main weapon. Oh! Okay. Let's just pop some drugs real quick, though. Oh my god. Alright. So it's like a giant circle of city.
Hey, oh. Kiddo. How are the paper sales?
Well, the presses are getting overloaded. That motor is going to go soon if we don't replace it.
You've been saying that for weeks and the old girl still keeps cranking. Stop worrying so much. I gotta head into the office. You start whistling if you see any angry politicians coming our way.
Why? Is something wrong? Piper?
Damn. The mayor? All Faith's Chapel? Okay. The Synthetic Truth. October 2287. The Synthetic Truth by Piper Wright. Noodles. We all eat them. We all love them. And Diamond City's power noodles has supplied this sustenance for the past 15 years. All from silted mechanical cadence of Takahashi's programmed Japanese, to the fragrant steam that wafts from each bowl, to the scalding tang of each delicious mouthful. The ordering and eating of noodles is but one of many shared human experiences, is it not? Or is it? I was struck by this very question as I sat at the counter of Power Noodles last Wednesday night, just after 5 p.m., enjoying a dinner I had so many times before. That's when I noticed our very own Mayor McDonald sidle up to a stool and engage in the very same ritual. Right hand extending, mouth opening, teeth chewing, yes, eating noodles. The shared experience of almost every Diamond City resident. So it must have also seemed the residents of Diamond City nearly 60 years ago on an uncharacteristically warm May evening in 2229 as they sat around this very same counter. But that was back in the days of Takahashi. It was back before the days of Takahashi and his noodles, when the bar served not noodles, but ice-cooled Nuka-Colas, frothy beers, and stiff shots of whiskey. The barman's name was Hendry, and that night, he facilitated the shared human experience of drinking, smoking, talking, and laughing. That is, until tragedy struck. There aren't many among us who are even old enough to remember that evening, although some of the city's ghoul revenants certainly could have, had they not been forcibly removed thanks to Mayor McDonald's anti-ghoul decree of 2282. But there is one person among us who does remember distinctively the events of that evening. Respected matriarch Eustace Hawthorne, who recounted her story on a public occurrence exclusive review. Oh, I was there, all right, sitting right at the bar, sure as you're sitting in front of me now, 22 years old or so, and just looking to have a good time. I was safe behind the wall. We all were. So what was the harm? And let me tell you that Mr. Carter made it easy. He came into town earlier that day. Said he was from out west. Somewhere. It didn't really matter. What didn't matter was his smile. His laugh. The way he'd make you feel at ease. That night at the bar, we just sort of crowded around him. Everyone wanted to exchange a word or hear about the state of the Commonwealth. And Mr. Carter, he was all too happy to oblige. He was just so wonderful. Until it wasn't. Eustace continued to recount that evening and the moment when things turned sinister and the truth about Mr. Carter was revealed. We'd been drinking and carrying on, must have been 3 hours. Mr. Carter had 4 or 5 drinks in at that time. He seemed a little drunk, I guess, like the rest of us. Then something just sort of happened. He was smiling, but the smile sort of went from his face all in an instant, and his cheeks started twitching kind of funny, and I remember watching him clear as it was happening just yesterday. He reached inside his coat, he pulled out a revolver, and bam! He shot Hendry and the barman right in the head. Didn't hesitate, didn't show any emotion. Mr. Carter killed Hendry as casually as if he was just paying him for a drink. But his cheek did never stop twitching. Let me tell you, all hell broke loose after that. What Eustace is describing is, of course, the infamous event known as the Broken Mask, when the people of Commonwealth learned for the first time that the Institute, a shadowy scientific organization responsible for the creation of combat androids, had actually succeeded in creating a model so advanced it could effortlessly infiltrate human society. Unbeknownst to the people of Diamond City, the Institute had somehow evolved their androids into true synthetic humans. Since. After he shot Henry, then Mr. Carter shot 4 or 5 other people too. Like I said, all hell broke loose. The guards came running, they opened fire, and Mr. Carter, he kept shooting and throwing people around left and right. Finally, those guards put him down. Seemed like he had killed a man who'd flipped his lid, gone crazy. And he lay there like a dead crazy man, sure enough. God, it was horrible. But then we saw the plastic and the metal. This was one of those early synths, you see. And we realized it wasn't a man at all. It was then we all knew the Institute wasn't just out there. The Institute was everywhere now, among us. It was never determined precisely why the synth known as Mr. Carter went on his killing spree. Some suggested he had been somehow been remotely controlled by the Institute, who wanted to test his combat effectiveness. Still, others felt he had simply malfunctioned, a hypothesis supported by the twitching cheek. It was never meant to kill anyone, but at that time, the why hardly seemed important. What mattered was that the humans of the Commonwealth had been truly infiltrated by an organization whose intentions and motives were, and still are, a complete mystery. Using a model of synth even less advanced than the ones the Institute has in service today. Which brings us to noodles. Specifically the noodles consumed by Mayor Dunland last Wednesday night. In the same spot that Mr. Carter and the synth went haywire, and mercilessly killed several people. After spending hours sharing an experience the people of Diamond City assumed was reserved for members of the human race, they were wrong. Are we? My God, that was intense. Oh, that's the same thing. Oh, public occurrences? That's the name of this paper? Okay, I guess I'll talk to her.
You holding up, Blue?
Blue?
Why are you calling me that?
Because you're a vault dweller? I know you're not wearing the blue jumpsuit right now, but the Pip-Boy and the fish out of water look... dead giveaways. So here's the deal. I want an interview. Your life story in print. I think it's time Diamond City had a little outside perspective on the Commonwealth. You do that, and I'll tell you what. I'll come with you. Watch your back while you get used to the world above ground.
What's involved?
What kind of interview is this gonna be?
I ask you who you are, get your opinion on life out there, and maybe load up a few tough questions and keep it interesting. What do you say?
Sure.
All right, Piper. I'm in.
Good. Let's get down to business.
To defeat
from a vault,
the Huns.
How would you describe your time on the inside?
The vault? We were frozen.
My family and I were frozen. I didn't spend much time in the vault.
Wait. They boxed you up in a fridge? The whole time? Are you saying you were alive before? Before the war?
Yes.
Yes. I'm over 200 years old.
Oh my God. The man out of time. So, you've seen the Commonwealth, Diamond City. How does it compare to your old life?
It kind of gives me hope.
Honestly, seeing everyone surviving out here, rebuilding the world, it gives me hope.
That's surprisingly inspired, Blue. We're definitely quoting that. Now, I already know you're looking for your son, Sean. Do you suspect the Institute was involved in his kidnapping?
I don't know.
I don't know.
No one ever does. That's what makes them so scary. For the last part of our interview, I'd like to do something different. I want you to make a statement to Diamond City directly. The threat of kidnapping is all but ignored in the Commonwealth. Everyone wants to pretend it just doesn't happen. What would you say to someone out there who's lost a loved one but might be too scared or too numb to the world to look for them?
Don't lose hope.
No matter how much you want to give up, don't. You have to have hope that you'll see them again. Or at least, that you'll know the truth.
A strong note to end on, Blue. Thanks. That's everything. It's gonna take some time to put this all together, but I think your story is gonna give Diamond City plenty to talk about. Anyway, I agreed to come with you, right? Watch your back? Just say the word when you're ready. I can't wait to see where the story goes next.
All right. I'm gonna need to find a good home for Dogmeat, though, before I do anything else. I'm gonna explore. There's her little sister.
Paper to newcomers. If the Institute grabs you in the night, at least we warned you.
Thank you.
Thanks, I guess.
I'm serious. The Institute takes people. You should read up if you're sticking around.
I believe you.
I believe you. Thanks.
You're a real lost lamb in the wolf's den, mister.
Nothing stays hidden forever. At least, not if I have my say.
I actually really liked that synthetic truth. The way that it was written was actually really well done. Yeah, I'm taking all your shit, sorry. Sharpshooter's hardened 10mm pistol. Don't mind if I do. I'm serious, don't mind. I'm taking it anyway.
Never thought a reporter could consider themselves a success until someone threatened their life. Me? I'm very successful.
I don't doubt that at all. So to Diamond City we go. Diamond City Market. Oh, there's children running around too, so it's not just her. That's good. It's good to know there's kids. Power Noodle. So that's where it all happened. Damn. The Super Saloon? Can I get a haircut?
Anyone is one of those things. It's that secretary of his. Her and her perfect hair.
Mm-hmm.
The mayor's secretary. Come on, Ma. I cut her hair myself, and I know human hair.
That's just it, Johnny. You wouldn't be able to tell the difference.
Damn!
McDonough, with your razor, he'd bleed. Don't mean nothing.
Hmm. Oh, wow. You're tall.
Well, hello there. Another one of the poor and stupid of Diamond City come begging for table scraps?
My dad's outside of street people.
I'm not sure what you said, Pete. I'm sorry. Okay.
I'm not supposed to talk to people I don't know.
I didn't refer to you. Okay. Okay, I
hear there's a bar in the old theater district that's for raiders only. The combat zone. I'd stay clear if I was you.
Okay. I suppose so.
Do yourself a favor and just say yes. It's all he understands.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, I'll buy a noodle cup. Thank you.
Everyone in this city is always jumping at Shadow. Chill out, is what I say.
So your name is Solomon?
Everyone else may be closed, but Diamond City Surplus is open 24 hours a day.
What do you sell?
What do you sell here?
Oh, everything, sir. Miss Myrna prizes herself on being a collector of quality odds and ends from all over the Commonwealth. We also buy any unwanted items you may be carrying on your person. And we're open 24 hours a day.
Sure.
All right, let's see what you got.
Oh, goody.
Okay, combat knife. Grenade, mines. Hunting rifle. That's always good. The price isn't really that bad between the two of them. I might... Submachine gun. Is that a Tommy gun? It's a goddamn Tommy gun. Well, okay. Wastelander's chest piece. Wow, that price is expensive. Okay. But I mean, that's a legendary piece, too, so, like, okay. A dick tall? Oh my god, that price! Cures all addictions? Oh, man. God damn. Do you have any Stimpaks? That's just for one Stimpak? Oh my god. What else you got? Bobby pins? I'll buy all your bobby pins. The Blast Radius board game. High-powered magnets. Nuclear material. I'm gonna have to remember all this. I need to make a list. And like put it on my secondary. No, do not. Okay, I'm fine with this trade. Okay then.
Word is something bad went down in the old Museum of Witchcraft up near Salem. Why would anyone even go there? Been abandoned forever.
Investigate the Museum of Witchcraft. Home plate. Well, I can put my power armor here if I were to walk it all the way over here. That'd be awesome. Have your prescription filled here. So Addictol looks the same as Jet. Interesting. Okay then.
Hi.
You know, it's actually seeing a city like this that I'm actually quite happy about. Oh, Fallon's basement. Don't want to go there. Commonwealth weaponry. Okay, big guy, I hear ya. Alright. I have found so much cool stuff thus far. I feel like I mean, I'm happy with what I found thus far. I'm just not really sure how to react to it thus far. Shock baton, I'll keep that at number one. And now that I know I can scrap weapons too, that's also very helpful. Put a shotgun right there. Well, I mean, like, instead of the shotgun, I guess I'll go with this guy. I can stab people? Oh my god. I don't know what that was. Oh my god, no!
I hear you've been asking questions around town. What? Diamond City's got two private dicks now?
I think I'm just gonna load from there. I forgot I had grenades equipped. Just for the sake of safety, let's unequip that.
You know what you're looking for? We have everything. I
say I'm careful. Dad says not to talk to strangers.
Okay, then don't talk to strangers, girl. It's okay. I'm not gonna Oh, okay.
What? You got a staring problem?
Not at all. Oh my god, radiation storm. Is that what this is? I need to find a place to go inside.
I heard from my cousin. He knows a guy that works for him. They got a code phrase and everything. Follow the freedom trail.
The hell is that supposed to mean? You're full of it, and that kind of talk is gonna get you snatched up.
Shoot people, mister? My dad says outside to shoot people.
Hi there.
No, I don't shoot people.
Hey there, mister.
Newcomer, huh? Talk to Abbott at the wall if you want to hear stories.
You read the paper?
Valentine yes. Detective Agency.
Hiding among us.
See Abbott at the wall. You know, first I'm gonna go in here and...
Told you your luck wouldn't last forever.
What? Oh, he's dead, isn't he?
His ties. Oh, Nick.
He's dead.
Something wrong?
Another stray coming in from the rain. Afraid you're too late. Office is closed.
It's annoying. I know you must be busy, but I won't take much of your time, miss. It's important.
You don't get it. The detective, he's gone. Missing.
Don't worry, I can help. Tell me what happened.
Nick was working a case. Skinny Malone's gang had kidnapped a young woman, and he tracked them down to their hideout in Park Street Station. There's an old vault down there that they use as a base. I told Nick he was walking into a trap, but he just smiled and walked out the door like he always does.
I'll find him. You have my word.
Thank you. Nick should be easy to spot. He's always wearing that old hat and trench coat getup. Please, hurry.